A changing climate affects everyone. To address the rapidly intensifying environmental, economic, and social consequences of climate change, we need diverse voices, especially those of women and girls. And women and girls are stepping up to the climate challenge as powerful agents of change. The UN Global Climate Action Awards recognize women-led climate solutions around the world. Entrepreneurs are wired to scale solutions with speed, and climate change requires urgent action. Elemental Accelerator exists to help entrepreneurs scale technology and deploy solutions to climate change faster than would be possible on their own.
What Elemental specifically invests in is the nexus between climate solutions and social equity. So we do this through thinking about equity into the companies. What does that look like for an actual startup? How do we build that into their DNA early? And then equity out. How are we ensuring that these solutions are providing access and equity for those who need it most, and those who will be most affected by climate change, and prioritizing that in our work with startups? Over the last few years, Elemental has looked at over 5,000 companies to invest in for impact. We fund about 20 companies a year. And this year, in our group of companies, about 50% of those are led by women, and almost 50% have a person of color as a founder on the leadership team. And we've seen that teams that have at least one woman on the executive team actually outperform teams that don't by 3-1 in terms of revenue in the early stages. And those are the companies that are best poised to be successful in our new economy.
As a landscape architect, Coach Konvor Kom is building innovative landscape solutions for urban resilience in Bangkok. Her firm has equipped the city with public green spaces and nature-based solutions to reduce Bangkok's flood risk and improve the well-being of its citizens.
So we are the flat city, so we incline the whole park to be able to collect the runoff to protect the city from getting flash flood. We also want to have the solution available for the climate vulnerable communities along the canal and those who live in the floodplain to figure out the climate change as a whole. We cannot just looking the same picture from different angle, but how those different angle can combine as one. Because normally when we want to fix flooding, we fix with concrete dams. We just put it into like protective solution that we don't want to get wet. But when you combine the natural process, you actually understand the change that this structure can actually adapt. So we are not talking about the fixed solution. We are talking about living solution and learn how to live with water rather than against it.
Health and Harmony reverses rainforest deforestation in Indonesian Borneo through women-led innovation. Together with local communities, the project established a medical center with discounts to communities that decrease illegal logging, as well as training former loggers in sustainable agriculture.
We do what we call radical listening, where Asri went to the community asking the community what would they need in order to stop logging.
Gunung Palung National Park, where we first started, we gave thank yous to those communities over the first 10 years of approximately $5.2 million. But that included building a huge medical center to provide healthcare. And in return, those communities gave back $65 million worth of carbon.
Nah, di situ saya setelah pertemuan Musdus itu, kita siapa sih menyampaikan tentang kelestarian hutan gitu. Bapak tahu enggak bahwa kita kalau zona kita ini di Asri itu ada diskon loh Pak, ada hijau. Saya bilang kalau kita menjaga hutan kita dapat diskon hijau loh Pak. Jadi lumayan kalau untuk berobat dapat 70% diskon. Jadi bagaimana caranya Bu? Nah, Bapak harus berhenti untuk menjadi menebang hutan, saya bilang gitu. Ada sekitar 3 bulan. Jadi 2 logger yang di tempat saya itu berhenti.
Marcia Verle is the founder and president of a Brazilian company that has found a way to reuse residual kitchen fats to produce biodiesel. In 13 years, her company has already helped to install 28 sustainable biofuel plants throughout Brazil, generating more than 1,500 direct and indirect jobs.
Na realidade, quando a gente começou o trabalho do Instituto, trabalhando a questão da educação ambiental, trabalhando a questão dessa coleta de óleo dentro das escolas, a gente percebeu que o grande monte assim, de trabalho que realizava era a mulher. Ela participava de todos os processos de coleta, né, do incentivo da coleta, da busca da coleta.
Então, a nossa inovação está na organização desses arranjos produtivos locais, né, para que seja uma solução para dentro das cidades, e envolvendo os diversos atores, né, desde a questão das prefeituras, escolas, né, então entra muito forte a parte da educação ambiental e o envolvimento da sociedade civil em torno desse projeto.
When we give people chance to really put their hands on something, they get more motivated and they see the effects of their actions. So when you take this cooking oil and we produce, for example, soap, they see this transformation of something bad into something good, and they feel empowered in a way that they can actually do something to preserve the environment.
Rise 2030 is a community-led initiative that focuses on empowering women and youth while improving living conditions through access to education and employment. Rise 2030 launched the first all-women solar team in Lebanon to challenge gender stereotypes in the male-dominated construction sector.
Getting women into leadership positions means that you have to start young and build a pipeline. Programs like ours form a foundation of opportunity for other women to not only get the initial training, but to experience opportunities for leadership.
I'm convinced that every experience is a lesson and that success comes from experience. And this was one of the wonderful experiences in my life. And now I am the trainer and supervisor for the new group. And this is the beginning and still have a long way to go.
This year was really hard in Lebanon. We first started with the financial crisis, then the COVID crisis, and in August we had a major explosion in Beirut. Our houses and the offices were destroyed from the past, yet we did not stop and we kept on working with relief projects to assist the people who were affected by the blast.
Women from around the world are playing a vital leadership role by tackling the climate challenge head on. The 2020 Women for Results Winning Climate Projects. Shining a light to show there's momentum for change. Change for good.